the NBA Hall of Fame, the immortal Kobe Bryant, the big fundamental Tim Duncan, and the big ticket Kevin Garnett. Now, the Hall of Fame is going to take place on August 29th here in the Sports Opinion Log, Lex Anderson World, right here at the helm. I will discuss the greatness of Kobe Bryant later. This video is dedicated to the not-so-great Hall of Famer Kevin Garnett, and I'm going to explain to you why. He might be Hall of Fame bound, but he's not as great as you think he is. So if you're down with all things NBA, Eastern or Western Conference, or you're just looking for something to watch to hold you down, I invite you to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay notified for any and all upcoming future videos. And on your way back down, make sure you're liking this video and drop a comment below letting me know why you think or don't think that Kevin Garnett is truly one of the greats. So let me break down to you the true numbers of Kevin Garnett and why he is not one of the greatest players to play in the NBA. Let's go. During his tenure with the Minnesota Timberwolves from 1995 to 2007, Kevin Garnett made the playoffs 8 straight times. And guess what? On those 8 straight times, they were all first-round exits. Can you imagine if Kevin Garnett had played in the time that LeBron James had played in the NBA, getting knocked out of the first round 8 times in a row? And by the time they did reach the Western Conference Finals in 2004, guess who they got knocked off by? Yeah, here it is. Kobe Bryant, Shaq, and the LA Lakers. So then he goes over to the Celtics. From 2007 to 2013, only one NBA championship. That's it. KG, the big ticket, Paul Pierce, the truth, Ray Allen, who had no goddamn nickname. 2007 to 2013, only one championship, which would label Kevin Garnett as being a playoff choke artist. Don't get it twisted, folks. Kevin Garnett, he might have a lot of accolades, but in 143 playoff starts, he has 70 wins to 73 losses. That means he's below 500. Now, to his credit, I will give Kevin Garnett this much. In 2008, he became the first Boston Celtic player to win Defensive Player of the Year award. But fuck that. Fuck Garnett and fuck the Celtics. So let's wrap up the rest of Kevin Garnett's pretty much lackluster career. At the end of 2013, him and Paul Pierce both go to the Brooklyn Nets, where from 2013 to 2015, he was old, he was broken down, he was useless, and did nothing for the Brooklyn Nets. And finally, like a horse being put out to pasture, he goes back to Minnesota 2015-2016, where he retires. Kevin Garnett did make history coming to the NBA straight from high school, being the first player in nearly 20 years since Moses Malone. Kevin Garnett was also one of the first $100 million players. Kevin Garnett was also one of the NBA's overpaid players during the course of his career. 8 straight years of first-round exits. Then you send him over to Boston to form a dynasty with Ray Allen and Paul Pierce. And from 2007 to 2013, only one measly championship to show for it. And then when he did have a good team behind him with Latrell Sprewell and Cassell, couldn't even get past the Lakers because Kobe Bryant was just that damn good. So Kevin Garnett, enjoy your ticket, big ticket, being punched, stamped. You're in the Hall of Fame. But the true sports fans or the sports historian, Lex Anderson, the top one percenter, the people's sportscaster, I know you for who you are, Kevin Garnett. You're a fraud. Thank you for tuning in. Again, make sure you're dropping a comment below letting me know where you stand on Kevin Garnett. Is he Hall of Fame worthy? Because we know he's been a, what, 15-time All-Star. I can't take that away from him. But all those years with only one chip to show for it, failure. Lex Anderson signing out.